That's life.
Pilot, VTR 112079, take uno, take take one.
I'd like to make love in an airplane.
A night away from my wife is the best thing for both of us.
I think today's teenagers are spoiled rotten.
Tired of being a sex symbol.
The honeymoon is over.
Yeah.
When the only night is Saturday night to make love.
I'd like to spend the last 5 hours of my life with my boots on and in the saddle.
The name of the game is That's Life, starring Mr. Nipsey Russell.
When the girls proclaimed me a model lover, I was so happy I wanted to sing. Then I looked it up, and model means a small representation of the actual thing. But I can tell you one thing. That's Life. That's the name of our show, and that's the theme of our show. I want to welcome you to That's Life, because we're going to give you a lot of laughs, we're going to have a lot of fun while you match your attitudes and your lifestyle against the attitudes and lifestyles of all other Americans. Now, we're also going to find out whether the men or the ladies know more about what's happening out there. That's going to be a difficult decision, because I hear that behind every successful man, there is a surprised mother-in-law. But we're going over here and meet these two teams now, beginning with this lovely creature here. Oh, man, this is just out of my dimensions, huh? Wow. Pleasingly pumped, I call this. Yes, sir. It is nice to be neat and look petite, but if you want to feel some heat, you got to have some meat. Yeah, man. Well, I guess that's enough about me. So tell us your story. Tell us your name and what you do.
Well, my name is Ea McMillan, and right now I'm a student.
Good. Good luck on the game tonight. Mary?
I'm Mary Anderson, and I'm from New York, and I teach dancing school.
Dancing school?
Yeah.
All right, tell us the Barbara story.
My name is Barbara Collier, and I'm married and have 2 children, and I sell artwork in New York.
You sell, have children?
Yes.
Little ones?
8 and 4.
8 and 4. Oh, that could be trouble.
Yeah,
I'll be back to talk to you. Let's meet the guys now. Tom? What's it all about now?
You got it. My name's Tom Burke. I'm a cadet at the police academy here in New York.
Oh, yeah, police. Gee whiz, I found out something about the police. You know, I didn't know the city pays you guys, too.
Well, yeah.
Anyway. Henry.
My name's Henry Quinn. I'm a retired special agent with the FBI.
Well, that's right. I didn't do it. Up against the wall. Okay, Jim, tell us the Jim story.
Hi, my name is Jim Cyrus, and I'm a truant officer.
You're a truant officer. So you're playing hooky. Be cool and be careful. Okay, guys, you know what it's all about. The game is called That's Life, and I just need 2 players to move into the playing position. So, E and Tom, you move up there, and we'll go right to our first dilemma. First, of course, I want to explain the game to you. You see, we have a running bank here. And we start with $3,000, and we add $250 to this bank every time one of the players makes a correct selection. However, if you make a bad selection, a wrong selection, look out, because there's a danger of your getting knocked out of the game by the opponent, right? Now, when one team knocks out the whole other team, then that winning team gets to come and play and break the bank, huh? Are we all set?
All right.
Well, that's life. So let's look at our first dilemma. We went out and we talked to a lot of women about things, all of the different aspects of life. By the way, did you know that 50% of married women today cheat on their husbands? 50%! Well, percentages don't help me. I need some names. We asked them to tell us what they thought about men, see, and we gave them 3 phrases with which to complete a given statement. They completed the phrase, "I think most men," by cheat on their women, hide their emotions, or love power. After all we heard, those were the 3 choices we gave them. Now, E, it's your job to try to determine what was the number one choice among those that they had.
Well, I'm going to go with hide their emotions.
Most men hide their emotions. Hide their emotions, rated number one. Now, to stay in the game, you got to come up with the number two answer.
Okay. I think most men cheat on their women.
Cheat on their woman. That's what you think the 100 women came up. Okay, cheat on that woman actually rated number three. Oh, knockout right from the beginning. That makes our teams unbalanced right away. We've got three over here with the ladies, and Tom, you go over there and hope that your guys can get you back into the game. All right? Good. All right. Two more players. We go to our next question. We talked in this question to 100 women, and we asked them to talk about love. However, before I give you the three choices with which they finally ended up, I want to show you a little film clip, and I'd like you to listen to what was said to me on the streets of New
York. In what unusual place would you like to make love?
I'd like to make love in an airplane.
In the office on a Sunday.
In front of a fireplace.
Uh-huh.
While watching an X-rated movie.
How about you? People fashion?
Well, when he said complete the statement, I'd like to make love, that sounded like a complete statement to me. Because I don't believe at love at first sight, that you're not likely to see. But I do believe in making love at the first opportunity. We gave the 100 women these choices. I'd like to make love in the ocean. On the grass. And in the shower. Okay, Henry, that ball's in your court. You try and tell us which of these responses rated number one.
Well, I would think that 100 women would like to make love in the shower.
In the shower. That's what you say, huh? Be careful you don't step on the soap. In the shower, rated number one. You're in the same zone of vulnerability now. There's a chance for a knockout on your team. It's 3-2 now. You got to come up with number two choice, or you get knocked out of the game. What do you think?
I'll choose on the grass.
On the grass. Yeah. On the grass, rated number three. Knockout time. Oh, you can cry on my shoulder.
Thank
That's
you.
All right. The game's not over. You got two on each team now. We need two more players. Okay, this time we asked the men. We asked 100 men to talk about life. And we wanted to talk about not only life in its present-day aspect, but the afterlife, when time comes to boogaloo to that great disco in the sky. And before I give you the choices with which they were left, I want you to look at some film. Listen to what they said to me on the streets of New York.
After reincarnation, I'd like to come back as Tarzan of the Apes.
As my wife.
Your wife?
She's got it made.
A very skinny, gorgeous movie star.
I'd like to come back as a plant.
I'd like to come back as a little fish frozen beneath the ice. Then when the girls went skating overhead, woo-woo, wouldn't that be nice? We gave them these three choices. To finish the statement, after reincarnation, I'd like to come back. I'd like to come back as a priest, as an eagle, or as a woman. Okay, Barbara, you're up. You've been a beautiful woman once. Which of those three answers you think rated number one?
I'm going to have to say woman.
Like to come back as a woman?
Yeah.
As a woman, rated number one! Wow! Jim, there's a frown on your face.
Yeah.
You wouldn't like to come back as a woman, huh?
No, I don't think I would.
Well, to come back or to stay here this time, you've really got to come up with the number two choice now. What do you think among the other two?
Well, it'd be too tough as a priest, so I'd say as an eagle.
An eagle, the good old American symbol. An eagle rated number 2! Wow! Good job! Well, that's a good choice. No knockouts that time. The game goes on, and we're up to Henry and E and a new subject. And we asked 100 women under the age of 30. Now, we don't deal too strongly with age here. A woman's age is her business. And a lot of them been in business longer than they admit. We asked them to deal with a sort of a quandary here. Some difficult situations in which they'd rather see their husbands. We asked them to complete this phrase. I'd rather see my husband in jail, in a hospital, or in bed with another woman. Because I think if she found him in bed with another woman, he'd wind up in the hospital and she'd be in jail. But Henry, that's yours to consider. Which of these three choices you think rated number one?
Well, I think they would probably go for in jail.
In jail. In jail rated number one. We got a ladylike thing going here now.
Uh-oh.
What would you think would rate number two? Do you want to get knocked out of the game now?
I know personally, if I saw my husband in bed with another woman, I'd probably shoot him.
Uh-huh.
So let's put him in the hospital instead.
Put him in the hospital.
At least he's alive that way.
All right, in the hospital, rated number 3. Oh, knockout time. Well, at least you didn't kill the poor guy off. And actually, you're not dead yet. Just go and wait on the mourner's bench with your partner, and maybe Barbara can get you and your team back into the game. All right? Henry, send old Jim up front again. Okay, we talked to 100 men. We talked to them about how they'd like to spend life, the last few moments of life. And before I tell you the choices which they had, I'd like you to look at a film clip. Listen to what they said to me on the streets of New York.
How would you spend the last 5 hours of your life if you knew when those hours were going
to
be?
You know what? I would like to remember all the good things what's happened with me through my life.
I think I'd like to be unconscious.
I think I'd like to spend 2 hours for dinner and 3 hours for love.
My boots on and in the saddle.
We'll ride tenderfoot ride. Boots on and in the saddle. Well, any guy that could be in the saddle for the last 5 hours of his life, we know why he's dying, don't we? Okay. They were left to complete this phrase. I want to spend the last 5 hours of my life getting high. Little personal identification problem out there, huh? Making love. Are calling all my friends. Well, everybody wants to go to heaven and nobody wants to die. So, Barbara,
that's your choice.
Yeah, now, of those three choices which they had, which do you think rated number one?
Oh, it's tough.
Yes, it is.
Making love. Let's go.
All right. Oh, you're still playing the game. Making love. Rated number one. Yes, sir. The young people say make love, not war, and I'm beginning to think they're right, because war costs millions of dollars a day and love just a few bucks a night. She got the number one answer there. Now, to stay in the game, and it looks like you're going to boil it down if you don't stay in the game, you got to come up with number two.
Got to be getting high.
You think getting high. Getting high rated number two. Oh. Man, good play, Barbara. We're back to Henry.
Yeah.
Let me see. What did we talk to? Oh, we talked to mothers this time. We ask mothers about their children growing up. I thought about that. While contemplating morality, one question comes to view. How do mothers find out about the things they tell their daughters not to do? Well, we ask those 100
to complete this statement. I'd hate to see my son grow up to be a soldier, sanitation worker, or a ballet dancer.
Yeah.
Okay, Henry, what do you think? Among those three choices, 100 mothers, what do you think was number one?
I think they would not like to see their sons be a soldier.
Yeah. All right, we'll see. Soldier rated number one. You're hanging tough, huh, Bob?
Oh, yeah, I'm trying.
Okay, Barbara, what do you think was the number two choice? You want to get some help from the peanut gallery?
I don't know. It depends. Are they sanitation workers?
Sanitation. Right.
What do you think?
Yeah, I'm going to go sanitation worker.
Sanitation worker. All right, for all the marbles this time, sanitation worker rated number... You played a good game anyhow.
Right.
So the team is all back. So now I guess you'll go over. Let's say goodbye to Barbara. Go over to the tower.
Hey!
Well, you did it, fellas. You see? Knocked them out. Congratulations. Now we're to the really important part. You got to go and try to break the bank. Right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's $5,000 there in that bank. A show without a commercial would really be a ball. But if we didn't have the commercials, there'd be no show at all. So we're going to wait for a commercial, then we'll come back and see if these guys can break the bank for $5,000. This bank, which started at $3,000 because of correct selections on both sides, is now $5,000. And you guys could win it all if you could make 9 correct selections from this board. Now I'll tell you how you do it. Tell you what we're going to do. You got to look up here and you see that across the top there, reading left to right, we have what we call 3 key words. Now the key words are Jane Fonda, diet, and infidelity. Under each of those keywords, we have 4 associated words. For example, under Jane Fonda, we have cause, loudmouth, anti-American, and integrity. Under diet, we have doctor, calories, fat, scale. Those words are associated with those keywords. Under infidelity, we have passion, hiding, guilt, and excitement. Now, we did a survey again, and the most popular choices or associations under those keywords are numbered 1, 2, and 3. That's what you're looking for under each keyword. What you don't want is that other choice, the bad choice. Because when you do, you get that's life, which means that's tough, because the game is over. So you're trying to avoid the name of this show, That's Life. So now, starting with you, Tom, take any keyword and go for any association.
All right, under diet, I choose fat.
Under diet, he chooses fat. Fat is number 1. Well, you got the idea. That's the way we associate the terms, okay?
Under Jane Fonda.
Jane Fonda.
I choose cause.
Cause. Cause is number 1. We don't want to find that's life yet, do we? Because
no.
If we did, the game would be over and you'd only have $200. Okay, go ahead. Pick a choice.
Under fidelity, I would pick...
Infidelity.
Oh, infidelity. Yeah.
We don't have much fidelity around here.
Infidelity, passion.
Passion. Passion is number 2. Give us a key word and give us an association.
All right. I've got to repeat now. Under Jane Fonda.
Jane Fonda?
I'll try Loudmouth.
Loudmouth. Loudmouth is number 2. I just want to make sure you understand. That means that under Jane Fonda, for example, there's only one more correct selection. There's one sign there that says, that's life. Same thing exists in the other two categories, but you pick any keyword and any association.
Okay, under infidelity.
Uh-huh.
I choose hiding.
I do, too. Hiding is number 1. The same principle applies here. The percentages go with diet, but you take any key word and any association you have in your mind.
All right, under diet, I'll take scale.
Scale. There seems to be a rising sound of protest there. Under diet, scale rates number 3. What's happened here?
Yeah.
We now, as we stand, have 6 correct selections for $600. Mm-hmm. Now, in each of the columns, there's just 1 correct selection. Mm-hmm. Also, there's that's life in each column.
Yeah.
All right, pick your choice.
All right, under diet.
Under diet.
I'll go with...
Calories.
Calories.
Okay. Let's hope you're right. Under diet, calories is number... 2! Wow. We're now 2 choices from $5,000. Jim, the ball's in your court.
Okay. Under infidelity.
Infidelity.
Guilt.
Guilt. You're going with guilt, huh?
Guilt.
Gee, I find it very exciting. Under infidelity, guilt is number 3. Okay, Henry. Now we're talking about a famous lady who's known for a lot of characteristics. Now, that's life is under that column. And it's life that you should be put to such a choice between anti-American and integrity. You got to give an association for Jane Fonda. Which is it?
Well,
they say integrity. What do you say?
Well, for Jane Fonda, I'll have to say anti-American.
Let's make sure we heard the right thing now. You said anti-American.
Anti-American.
Under Jane Fonda for $5,000, anti-American is number... They tried to tell you, and you didn't break the bank, but you wound up with, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, $800 in you. Right, is that right? Yeah, $800. Well, and we repeat so often on this show, that is life, but that's not really tragic, because you didn't break the bank that time, but it keeps building until someone does break it. And as long as you keep playing the way you did in the first game, as long as you keep beating your opponents, you come back and try for it again. So we got to get another team of challengers here for you, and we'll do that as soon as we get this commercial break. Have won $800, and we've had a lot of fun, and when we come back tomorrow, we'll have a bank of $5,000 still standing. We'll have some more interesting comments from people on the street and more surprising survey results. Our team will be back with a brand new team to challenge them. So until then, this is Nipsey Russell saying don't worry about money. If you owe too much on your American Express and your Diners Club bill is too large, take a loan on your Bank AmeriCard and pay it off with your MasterCard.
If you like this, make sure to subscribe to my channel for more. And check out my Facebook page for other exciting content.